four Scouse strangers.
I've been blessed by the gods.
Nice people get nowhere.
It's Rick.
Eggos.
Each trying to host the perfect dinner party.
They look a little bit like breast implants.
We are anticipating a special guest.
Scoring each other in secret with £1,000 at stake. Ooh. Expect top-end houses.
Does wealth bring happiness?
Who has a lift in their house, please?
Apparently so.
Middle-of-the-road food.
There was a funny smell coming from the fish.
And low-rent celebrities.
I got the chicken.
Do I make you horny? Do I make you randy?
This week, we're in Merseyside, home of the Liver Building. Legend has it that the Liver birds would flap their wings and fly if a virgin passed below. Fat chance. And if you find that hard to believe, then wait till you meet our first host, full-time mum, Kate McDonald.
You've all got to believe in something, and I believe in fairies.
Weirdo.
See, that one there, my little boy believes in them. My husband doesn't. He thinks I'm absolutely cuckoo.
Can't say I blame him.
You're not allowed to say, I don't believe in... I mean, I would say it properly. Every time you say that, one dies.
I don't believe in fairies. Oops, that's another one gone.
If someone says that in my house...
Should we be letting her near knives? Anyway, for her main course, Kate is making beef in orange sauce with mustard mash and sparkly glittery fairy magic.
Sounds right up my street.
Liverpool's hit music station.
I'm Rick Vaughan. This is Radio City 96.7. Thanks for switching us on.
Meet contestant number two, local radio DJ Rick Vaughan.
The real Rick Vaughan is the person you're looking at right now. Good-looking, humorous, witty. Did I mention good-looking?
Sadly, yes.
A lot of people would look at me again and say, oh, you're a celebrity, you're this guy, you're that guy. But if somebody is very fortunate enough in life to be born with a gift and they can show that gift to people, then good on them.
You're a DJ on local radio?
Celebrity culture is a complete waste of space, isn't it? You know, and I sit in the hairdressers and I read magazines with celebrity things and I think, what do they do?
Not a heat reader, then. This week's third competitor is straight-talking lady of comfortable means, Kathy Frost.
Well, my husband's reasonably successful, does it? You know, has got a good business and we've been lucky.
Very lucky.
Yes, I'm just an ordinary working-class girl from Birkenhead.
Who owns a fountain? Back in Fairyland, Kate's frying onion and peppers before adding diced beef to the pan.
Ow! Burn me before my finger.
Careful! She transfers the mixture to a slow cooker and adds beef stock.
I've just realised I've forgotten the most important thing. An orange, considering it's called beef and orange.
Yeah, that might help.
Ow, just grated me hand.
Yeah, that won't help. She adds orange juice and zest to the mixture.
The orange looks like little floaters.
Nice image. She leaves the beef to slow cook and it's onto the starter. Leek and potato soup with, you guessed it, fairy sprinkles.
I must admit, there's times in the past when I've dressed up as a fairy for parties. That's a different story.
And one we really don't want to hear. This week's lineup is completed by artist, life coach, raconteur, you name it, he's done it. Peter Worthington.
I think I'm a happy person because I've learnt over years it's no good being unhappy. So I feel happy at whatever I've got. If I've got no money, I'm happy. If I've got lots of money, I'm happy. If I've got friends around, I'm happy.
Do you think he's happy? Meanwhile, Kate sweats garlic, onions and leeks before adding potatoes and finally vegetable stock.
I'm going to leave that now for 40 minutes just to let it bubble away and let the potatoes soften. So that's cool. So now it's pavlova time.
Indeed it is.
This is the one that I'm most nervous about because I've only done it once before. Ooh. If it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Ooh, bit of shell there to go with it.
Great start. For dessert, Kate is making pavlova with fairy fruit and clotted cream.
More fairies.
I think if you offered that and my menu, I would choose my menu. And I think other people would.
So the pressure's on Kate as she whisks egg whites and sugar to make a meringue. Oh, dear. It really shouldn't be that hard.
I'm stuck. How do I get that off?
With the meringue in the oven at last, Kate turns her attention to the furry fruit.
I don't know what a fairy fruit is, apart from a fairy fruit, like a kiwi fruit, slightly fairy on the outside.
It's normally with fairy fruit to throw that away, it's off.
Well, let's clear things up. Kate cakes her cream-covered meringue in fairy fruit, which actually is just fruit.
That is just amazing. You can't possibly ruin it by putting fairy dust on.
Oh, yes, you can.
Oh, it's like magic beans.
Ever heard that less is more?
Ta-da! I love it. Dead happy. I'm going to put it in the fridge.
Please do. My fillings are aching.
Oh, my God, I don't want to eat it. It looks that good.
Glad rags on, and Kate's ready to welcome her first guest into the fairy grotto. And fittingly, it's gnomish life coach Peter.
Peter.
Hiya, Peter. Nice to meet you. I'm Kate.
Hello, Kate.
Okay, it's Tim. Come on in. Oh, thank you very much.
Next in is the lady of the manor, Kathy.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
And you.
Kathy.
Hiya, Kathy. I'm Kate. Who do we think's going to be next?
I think it's going to be a female.
Even I can't be that lucky, and I've been blessed by the gods.
Oh. What with smarm?
But then again...
You never know.
Talking of smarm, here's self-proclaimed gift from the gods, Rick.
Hello.
Hello there.
How are you?
Great. Nice to meet you. I'm Rick.
And you are you, Rick? I'm Kate.
Hello,
Come on
Kate.
In. Come on in. Take a seat. Everybody's through there. Cheers, guys.
Cheers. Cheers. Coming up, bewilderment.
It's just terrible.
Bizarreness.
Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
Which was a bit bizarre.
And battle stations.
I was more than happy last night to let Pete have his sort of 5 minutes of fame, and I'm prepared to let that continue up until a point.
Mad Merseyside mum of one, Kate McDonald, is throwing a dinner party for three strangers in a bid to win £1,000 cash prize.
So what do you do, Rick?
My main job is I work for Radio City.
Oh, do you? Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. So I work there.
Fab. What do you do there?
Radio show. I do 10 in the morning till 2 in the afternoon.
Oh, grill.
That's the one.
That's where I know your voice from, then.
You've actually heard of him?
Yes. It's none of them dodgy numbers you've been ringing.
No.
Maybe he does those as well.
They kind of put two and two together and said, oh, I recognise the voice, or I've seen you, or someone similar to that.
When he said, I'm Rick Vaughn, I was like, yeah, and, you know.
Do you guys want to come and take a seat? Sit down.
Please, let's go, yeah. Go on.
Yeah. Follow me.
Go on.
Thank you.
Age before beauty.
Thank you. More like wealth before wannabe. Kate puts the finishing touches to the starter. She adds cream, croutons, and it's ready to go. Leek and potato soup with fairy sprinkles.
In your little pots there. Yeah. OK, if you just open them up.
That's cute.
OK, you've got magic dust. What I want you all to do is, after three, we're going to clap our hands three times and say, I believe in fairies, and then you've just got to chuck your dust up in the air.
So, okay. Clap.
One, two, three.
I believe in fairies.
Woo!
I love it.
I'll tell you what,
I liked that. So what is the connection, then, with the fairies, if you don't mind me asking?
I've just believed in them since I was 4 years old.
Do you believe they do something, or that they exist, or what is it? What's
I
the
believe
crack?
That they are there and around and about to look after you.
Bit of glitter, bit of showbiz, bit of bubbles. I'm happy.
Showbiz? Oh, you mean you?
She's sort of stuck in this childhood thing about the fairies and... You know, but I think it's... I'm not knocking her for that. I'm not. I just don't get it, that's all.
Why aren't you eating your soup? Don't you
like
it?
Because... No. No.
Seriously?
Kate didn't eat her soup, so that was kind of a faux pas for me.
I don't think the fairy dust really affected the taste, but the pink colours... Just a little bit off-putting...
Bad luck, Peter. Wait till you see the main. She's even coloured the mash pink. Yummy!
They look a little bit like breast implants, but, you know, we'll get them out anyway.
More like Jordan's cast-offs, you mean? Here it is, beef in orange sauce with that weird mustard mash and, of course, more fairy magic. Yay.
I'm just going to check. This blue dust is edible, isn't it?
No.
All right.
Don't I told you. Don't eat the blue dust.
That's it. Have I got blue on my teeth?
While the guests tuck into their second dose of fairy magic, chat turns to other sorts of small people.
And do you want more kids, is it, in general, or are you not sure about that yet?
I'm not sure about that. I don't know.
You don't want him to be an only child, though, would you?
Well, we could get a dog. Have you got any kids, Rick?
I have two kids. My daughter's a teenager, and my son's just getting onto that now, past that. So, yeah, they're good.
I was very surprised when Rick said he had children, because I thought he was gay.
He isn't gay.
And not that gay men can't have kids, obviously.
Maybe he's a gay dad and he's adopted two kids. Or maybe he's just had two kids before he was gay.
He's not gay.
Maybe he's just not gay. I'm just really quite pretty.
Look, he isn't gay.
There's absolutely nothing wrong if he was gay. But I'm just none the wiser.
Rick is not gay! Have you got that, everyone? Now let's get back to the food. And once again, the host hasn't touched hers.
It's nice. I can't eat that. I don't like it.
You don't eat your own food, do you, girl?
No. Don't like it.
I didn't like my potato. I thought the look put me off it. The sort of blob on the plate of pink, sort of dog sickish looking things.
Presentation absolutely fantastic for a children's party.
Meat and two veg for a main course. You can't go far wrong. But she kind of did.
If you could swap places with anybody, who would it be?
Louise Redknapp.
Why, can she cook?
Well, that was obviously...
I wonder why.
Yeah,
that's a good answer, actually.
Peter?
Me? Oh, no doubt. Johnny Depp's wife. Because Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
Peter's the only thing we should know about you.
Are you gay, Peter?
Are you coming out
here? Are you gay?
Here we go again.
No, but for Johnny Depp, yeah, probably.
Oh, the love that cannot be.
He fancies, you know, Captain Jack Sparrow. Which was a bit bizarre.
I personally prefer women, but I can fully understand when women go for those sorts of men.
What would you do with £1 million?
Pay off my debts.
My God.
You've got £1 million worth
really?
Of debts.
Slightly under, yeah.
Half, yeah.
Oh, my God.
You need to go bump.
Got to a little Luke in your
ear. That's the one. More like a share guy.
I'm very curious now.
It doesn't matter how much money you owe. It's only the amount of money you've got left that you can pay. You know, when you've got nothing left to give to anyone, they can't chase you anymore.
I don't know, I'd be like...
I'm not sure about that.
It was something that we were really not expecting. As to whether that's completely true, I'm not too sure. I don't possibly think it is £1 million.
I still owe £350,000.
To have that amount of money and that debt hanging over your head... I think it would. I wouldn't like it. I wouldn't feel happy.
Let's recap, Pete. You want to live with Johnny Depp?
Yeah.
Okay. You've got £1 million worth of debt, and you've never been happier.
Yeah.
Cheers, Pete. Hope to be in your shoes for the day.
And from the ridiculous to the even more ridiculous.
Dun, dun, dun. I love it. Looks fab.
It looks radioactive.
The main course was so. Hopefully, this will pull me back.
Well, I guess anything's possible when you believe in fairies, Kate. There we have it, more kids' party food. Fairy fruit pavlova.
It's colourful.
I like the colour in it, yeah.
Yeah, it's got
plenty
of colour going on.
It's like something you see in The Simpsons.
Or in a dentist's nightmare.
We're all going to be on a sugar buzz after this.
With glucose levels rocketing, the host seizes the opportunity to pop her ultimate question.
Do you believe in fairies?
No, absolutely not.
I'm going to be more diplomatic than that.
No, I'm just being... absolutely not.
Another fairy bites the dust?
I think, listen, if you believe in something like that and it's what you believe in, then good on you.
Yeah. I believe in taxis.
That dessert, it's sort of... It reeked of Kate all over.
I don't think she takes herself too seriously, so I like that about her.
She's a nice person, but as many of us will know, nice people get nowhere.
The food let her down, so I'm just giving it a 4.
I'm only going to give her a 3.
She was a great hostess,
And for that reason, I'm giving her a 7.
So, not the fairy tale ending she was hoping for. Kate scores just 14. It's day 2. Peter's turn to host, and he's already decided who his main rival is.
Rick is the show-off entertainer type who likes to be noisy and loud and get people's attention.
I was more than happy last night to let Pete have his sort of 5 minutes of fame and tell us all about himself and the antics he's got up to. They were great stories.
He likes to put his viewpoint across and talk about things that he does, which is great.
I'm prepared to let that continue up until a point.
How very generous of you. Meanwhile, Pete gets cracking. He separates egg yolks for Duchess potatoes, the accompaniment to his main course of roast beef.
That's perfect.
Well, it's a bit boring, isn't it?
Au contraire, Cathy, because dinner's in the hands of an old pro, apparently.
I was originally trained to cook as a classical French chef some 30-odd years ago.
Oh, très bien, Pierre! He adds yolks to mash.
I prefer not to use a masher with potatoes.
No, that'd be far too easy. Anyway, Peter pipes his potatoes into perfect piles, sort of.
Sometimes, of course, you do still get lumps in.
Maybe the mash error wasn't such a bad idea after all.
And now that I've piped them, I can set them to one side to put in the oven later.
Pete will cook his rib of beef and the remaining veg 2 hours before serving. Then he makes a start on the meringue topping for the dessert. Or tries to. He's serving that retro pud, baked Alaska.
Which is very 70s-ish.
Like our host.
Lovely, perfect.
It is the most complicated of the three dishes, but if he gets it right, it's a showstopper.
Well, at the moment, the only thing that's stopped is Pete.
Of course, at French classical training school, we never used electric whisks. We always used hand whisks.
Naturally.
Halfway through the whipping, before it goes too stiff, add a bit of sugar. Whoops, a lot of sugar. And then that stops it separating when it goes firmer.
Meringue prepped. That's all he can do for the time being. Next, Peter bakes the homemade bread that will accompany his starter. Seafood and asparagus.
OK. Seafood. Pete?
I love asparagus and I love seafood, but I didn't think the two went together.
Pete will cook the first course when his guests arrive. Garbed in his formal attire, Pete's ready for guest number one. The man who's too cool to tie a tie, or doesn't know how, more like, local radio DJ Rick.
Hello, Rick. Nice to see you, mate. How are you?
Are you OK?
I'm good.
I brought you one of these, as I'm giving one to all the guests this week.
There you go.
Like Rick, it's coated in pure ego. Next, it's the fairy queen of Scousers, Kate. Peter's final guest is the landed lady in red, Kathy.
Go and get your door, Peter, I'm hungry.
Make yourselves comfortable.
Hello!
While Peter plates up his starter, his guests peruse his paintings.
That is self-portrait, I'm assuming. Yeah. Yeah.
He's got no nose, though. Looks like Michael Jackson.
I just think there's another side to this guy. I think he's played you two big time.
In what way?
I just think he's, last night, he's come across as this sort of guy, not a pot to pee in, you know, and like, just happy-go-lucky, pour me a drink.
I didn't know that. You know that one, though.
It's a competition at the end of the day. We all want to win, and I do think Rick maybe is playing a little bit of a game.
Maybe by suggesting that he's got Kate and I fooled by, you know. Maybe that's kind of putting Peter down a little bit.
These are frozen, yes, because you get good-sized prawns frozen, and you know they are really fresh.
Frozen's not fresh, but at least they've got someone's attention.
It would be horrible if you're eating your food and you get cat hair around the edge of the plate.
I hope he hasn't had that cat on the counter all day.
So do I.
In this heat.
Don't.
You don't want to know.
Go on, Dolly. It's hot. It's hot. You'll have to give it a few minutes.
Asparagus done to death, Pete fries his defrosted seafood in butter, then serves to make a random combination of seafood and asparagus.
Very nice.
Mm.
It's It's nice, this, Pete.
Hmm. That's just quite delicate, that.
That's one way to describe it.
The asparagus was a bit floppy. It was like... you could have whipped someone with it.
And the seafood was completely overcooked.
There was a funny smell coming from the fish.
It tasted nice to me, so hopefully my guests enjoyed it.
Yes, on Planet Pete.
Does anything ever upset you, Pete? Does anything rile you?
Even your voice is chilled out, isn't it?
Yeah.
So
I'm like that. Just sitting here watching you go.
Quite a few years ago, I was an assistant probation officer, and the guy I worked with used to use hypnosis to regress the prisoners, and I picked up hypnosis off him. And over a couple of years, I've worked on it quite a bit.
Do me.
You'll be regret that.
She wants to be done.
I want to be a fairy. I said straight away, yeah, I'd love to be hypnotised, blah, blah, blah. But I don't know if I'd quite like to be hypnotised by Pete. I think he'd... I don't think I'd ever wake up.
I can well believe he could put somebody to sleep by talking to them, to be honest with you.
He's done hypnotherapy and he's an artist and he's a life coach and, you know, it's like his CV must be pages and pages long.
Well, our jack-of-all-trades host is currently sawing his way through the beef.
It's a lovely tender joint, this.
You could have fooled me, but it's ready to go anyway. Roast beef with Duchess potatoes and seasonal veg.
It's always nicer when somebody else does it for you.
Yeah.
Well, doesn't it always taste nicer when someone else cooks?
Yeah, that's the theory.
The beef was overcooked for me. It was dry.
The vegetables were all a bit grey looking.
He'd done his little potatoes in a little whipped thing, which my dinner lady used to do. It's not good.
Still, at least the conversation's tasteful.
Do you do life drawings?
Used to, yes, did quite you, often, yeah. I think I may well be doing one this week, actually.
Is volunteering herself on?
Am I, yeah.
There's a couple tucked away in a bedroom you could look at.
If he offers to show you his etchings, just say no.
That's an offer, isn't it?
Yeah. All right, please. Don't be shy.
I'll get these two. They're only pastels, and they've done quite a while ago. These are quite old, and these were done for teaching.
Wow.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Looks like me.
I was going to say, oh, there's me. Photograph. Big boobs, red hair.
Yeah.
But no, boobs aren't big enough.
Oi, Rick, you've been looking.
I wouldn't let him paint me naked, no. No, 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 no.
What if he told you a little joke first?
Right, so he used to do a bit of stand-up comedy because he used to run bars and clubs. You know.
You're going to give us a sample?
Yeah, go on.
Go on, go on, go on.
Go on, go
on.
Go for it.
Go on. I walked by a shop the other day and I saw a 50-inch plasma TV, can't turn the volume down. I thought, stuck on full, I thought, well, I can't turn that down.
Get off!
We'll go on to the others. All right, then, we'll go to the others.
Pete tonight came out with another revelation that he was a stand-up comic.
I don't know who taught him, but they're not very good at the job.
For his next comic creation, Pete smears meringue over ice cream and a flan base.
The only tricky thing about this is the speed. You've got to get it all in the oven while the ice cream's still frozen.
And judging by that, you've failed. Here it is anyway, Pete's Baked Alaska.
Actually, that was quick. You did that.
It's got to be, but not quick enough, I don't think.
Well, it's definitely funnier than his jokes.
I'm not. Oh, God, the giggles.
Are you
OK? I'm fine, I've got no giggles.
Have another
sip of wine. Oh, what's Kate found on a spoon? Don't wipe it on the table.
Pete, I apologise for these two.
Better get them out of here. Taxis!
It's just terrible. It was just chopped up. Stale bread with six different flavours of ice cream. Oh, and I felt really mean, but then I found a cat hair and I pulled it out and I had to wipe it on the dining table really carefully. But I got the giggles.
Really, really good fun. It's been a funny... I've laughed so much.
The starter was overcooked, the main was overcooked, and the dessert wasn't cooked. For that, Pete gets a 5.
I'm going to give him a 6.
The pudding was poo, so I give him a 6.
He might have only scored 17, but that's enough to put Pete top. Coming up, it's cards on the table.
Rick is very camp.
Are you gay?
The host has something up his sleeve.
We are anticipating a special guest to deliver the main course.
And Rick riles Kathy.
It was patronising for Rick to say, I'm doing this for you people who may never meet celebrities.
Day three in Merseyside, and it's local DJ and shameless self-publicist Rick Vaughan's turn to host.
I don't really know the real Rick Vaughan. I don't think any of us know him.
Of all of the guests at dinner, I think he's the one that makes me more curious because he doesn't reveal anything about himself.
Well, let's see how much Rick Vaughan you can handle.
I've been very fortunate to get some great stuff sent to me that's been Vaughanified with Rick Vaughan on, like the Rick Vaughan chocolate bar. Brilliant. I love this.
Warning, may contain nuts and can induce vomiting.
I think there's a lot more to see with the Rick Vaughan factor. And hopefully tonight, when the guys arrive, I will deliver, hopefully, two things that they've not delivered on the past two nights. Do you want to ask me what they are?
Not really, but go on.
Good food and entertainment.
It doesn't get much smugger than that. Rick begins by blitzing tomatoes for the tapenade that accompanies his starter. Rick's peppery prawns.
Absolutely Rick down to the T. Promoting himself all the time.
Pretty easy. Prawns are dead easy.
After grilling peppers on a high heat, Rick puts them into individual ramekins and adds the prawns.
What I am going to do is put some cling film over these guys, just to keep them fresh in the fridge.
Brilliant. He returns to his massive pink fridge for the main course. Rick's, of course, roast chicken and vegetables, served by a special guest. Ooh, I wonder who that could be.
It's going to get us all drunk and have some celebrity there so we don't notice how bad the food is.
I've done it not for me, because I'm fortunate enough to be able to see these people on a regular basis.
Wow, is it Elton John?
I think the special guest might be a stunt double for Rick.
This is for Kate, for Pete, for Kathy. It's escapism. I want them to come here and forget your troubles, come on, get happy.
It's got to be Elton!
I've got a mixture of roasting vegetables here that I'm going to put on the base of this foil tray and then place the chicken, actually, on top of them.
Amazing.
Chicken goes on top of those guys, just like that. So that's done now. I'm just going to cover it in tin foil and let it sit at room temperature till it's ready to go into the oven. An hour and a half. Roast chicken. Done.
Nice one, Delia. On to tonight's final course dessert. Summer fruit pudding.
I'm sure that the fact it hasn't got Rick in front of the summer pudding is just a typographical error, isn't it?
As long as it's got cream, then it'll be all right.
That'll be nice. Wonder if he'll bake it himself.
Nope, because there's no baking required for this one. Rick sieves reduced summer berries, then cuts the crusts off bread.
So there's the top and there's the sides.
He lines his bowls, adds the fruit and some of the remaining juice.
From there, it's just a case of lid on top, press down. Some of the juices will overflow. That's absolutely fine. Don't worry about that. We just need to get a little bit of tin foil, put it on the top and a weight on it and in the fridge. And that is it done. Fingers crossed. Here goes.
All our host has to do now is make sure he's grilled on a high heat for 9 minutes, throw on a leather jacket and medallion and bung the chicken in the oven. Just in time for tonight's first arrival at Camp Rick. It's laid-back life coach Peter.
Hey, Rick, how are you? How are you?
You all right?
I'm pretty good.
Yeah, baby.
Don't get too excited. The special guest is arriving later. Austin's just serving champagne. Next to enter Rick's pink penthouse is Away with the Fairies, Kate.
Do I make you horny, baby? Do I make you randy? I hope you hey.
And last in, it's wealthy woman of the world, Kathy.
Hello. Hi. Oh, look at you.
You look lovely.
Oh, yeah,
oh,
baby.
Oh, my God, baby.
Oh, my God, you're a bit more like.
Will you be serving us dinner?
I am your dinner, baby. This will get you swinging, baby.
While Austin Powell's dad and Rick share a glass of pink champagne, the guests have a snoop round the apartment.
Oh, that's nice. That's...
Yeah, he's got a lovely body. Mm. Hello, Rick.
Ah, the wonder of Photoshop.
Oh, my God.
Oh, yes. Rick Vaughn champagne. He even drinks himself.
Everywhere you go, it's Rick, 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 Rick.
Love letters of great men.
Are they all his letters?
Rick is very camp. He is camp. You know, I mean, we don't even know him properly.
Back in the kitchen, the Prince of Pink spreads tomato tapenade onto toasted rolls, then plates up his prawns topped with grilled mozzarella. And there you have it, the starter, Rick's peppery prawns.
This is a question we all want to ask you.
OK.
But are you gay? Is it...
No.
Why the pink? Why the pink, then? Is that just...
The pink, I just came across, really, because I got the pink fridge.
Yeah.
And I bought, seen the toast, then they came out, I seen the kettle. And before you know it, I had lots of utensils that were just that colour.
But you know, you wear, like, pink and things, and you're like...
Because I got no problems. Yeah, I got no problems with it.
He says he's not gay, so he's not gay.
That clears that up, then. Let's move on, shall we? How about some thoughts on the grub?
This is exceptional, I will say.
The thing I liked about Rick's starter was the mozzarella on the prawns.
I loved the starter. Very simple. But nice.
Starter gets the thumbs up then. So Rick puts the mixed veg and spuds on for his main, and it's time for a big announcement.
I'd like to introduce you to some special people.
Must be Elton time!
They are my house band, Three Queens and a Keyboard.
Let's give them a big
round. Oh, well, don't worry. Elton must be coming later.
Food, glorious food. Hot sausage and mustard.
Somebody's pleased with himself.
While we're in the mood. Oh, jelly and custard.
That was just amazing. That was really, really good. It just got the night going.
Rich gentlemen have it, boys, in digestion.
They gave out some quality tunes tonight.
Que sera, sera.
I thought the entertainment of the band was brilliant, but I don't think you would do something like that if you didn't want to, you know, perpetuate the gay thing. Why would you?
But he's not gay, Kathy. Back in the kitchen, and it's almost time for the main event.
We are anticipating a special guest to deliver the main course. He should be here any second now. And it's going to be a real thrill for the guys, I think.
Well, there it is, Rick's roast chicken, about to be served by a very special guest. Here he comes!
We just need the chicken as promised for the roast, and I thought it'd be a great idea to get it served up for you guys by none of this nonsense, a true celebrity.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Elton... Hang on a minute, who's that?
Look at that! Isn't that the finest chicken you've ever seen?
Dean Sullivan, everybody.
Oh, it's Jimmy Corkill from Brookside. Yeah, well, Elton must have been busy.
Thanks so much.
Jimmy Corkill.
Calm down.
Thank you.
I grew up watching Brookside, Jimmy Corkill and Jackie. And then he is walking out. All right, I got the chicken.
Do you know what? And that was one of the big things about tonight and my night in general. I wanted to try and create that sort of celebrity feel to the night for us, just so it was memorable for you, that's all.
Thank you, oh great one.
It was slightly patronising for Rick to say, I'm doing this for you people who may never meet celebrities, because he thinks that, you know, we're all no marks.
Go on, there you go. Famous person.
Oh, famous person. I've met Bill Clinton.
Have you?
Had dinner with Bill Clinton, and he looked down my dress, looked down my cleavage.
A lot of men do that.
No, I met the Queen, and she was really cute, actually, because she's only little.
Amazing experience.
And it was nice to go home and say to my kids, I met the Queen today.
Yeah? Back at you, Rick.
We'd had, you know, maybe little celebrities that we've all kind of met, but not the President of the United States. That's big.
I mean, I've met Prince Charles a dozen times. I've only been to two of the Queen's garden parties. But I don't feel the need to talk about it.
You just did. Let's roll out the red carpet for the food.
The chicken was cooked to perfection.
Those roasties were lovely. They were done in goose fat, and I love goose fat.
So far, so good in his bid for the £1,000 prize. Time for the final act of the evening, dessert.
It's perfect.
Of course. Here it is, summer pudding, this time served by Rick Vaughn himself.
Ooh.
Here we go, guys.
This looks very posh, doesn't it?
Mmm.
That's how I feel.
That was lovely.
Mm. You okay?
Need an ambulance, Pete?
Not your thing, Pete.
No, it's lovely.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm. Is it okay for you, Pete? Is the acidity okay for you?
It's absolutely fine.
The little holes around your mouth where you missed.
What? Little holes
around your mouth where you missed. Apparently.
Look at Pete. It's actually a Pete.
I couldn't have put it better myself.
Even though I didn't like really like Rick's pudding, he was a great host and it was a great night.
Rick, he was an excellent host, excellent entertainer, and I've got to give him a 9.
Tonight, I am going to give Super Rick a cool dude 9.
Tonight, the food was good, not fantastic, and the entertainment was spot on, and for that reason, I'm going to give Rick an 8.
So, Rick's showbiz bash puts him into the lead with a colossal 26.
If anybody was to say to me, oh, Rick, you're kind of lucky tonight because you're in the entertainment industry and you know a few people so you can hit them up for favours, I'd say to those people, come on into the entertainment industry.
Yeah, well, local radio. It's the final day and the turn of Merseyside Moneybags, Kathy, to host. And after last night, she's got her work cut out.
I think I've got some pretty high expectations with Kathy.
I definitely think Kathy can pull it off tonight. She's a dark horse.
God, yes, I'm a better cook than Rick. Yeah. I haven't actually had any famous people around my house.
This is it. Cross swords, dueling banjos.
No, I am, sorry. I'm having Rick Vaughn here tonight for dinner. There you go.
Clash of the Titans. Cannon and ball.
I bet they're your mates too. Kathy begins by boiling cream and sugar for just one of her trio of desserts. Lemon posset, passion fruit sauce and strawberry shortbread.
Interesting. Interesting.
Ooh, that sounds nice, doesn't it?
Doesn't it just? Once the cream for the posset has cooled, Kathy adds lemon juice and zest, pours into shot glasses and sets aside to cool. She makes simple shortbread biscuits.
I don't want anyone saying I've bought my shortbread.
And finally, a sauce from passion fruit and lemon curd.
That's it, in the fridge. Chill.
Next, Kathy sears the meat for her main. Peppered fillet of beef with spiced vegetables.
Get in there, that's what I wanted.
Again, we're getting the predictable meat and two veg scenario.
Hang on, you serve chicken and veg.
Because Kathy's doing a fillet of beef, with a fillet it'll be cooked in a very particular way.
Spot on, Sherlock.
I'm going to wrap it in the foil to keep it hot, and the heat from the foil kind of cooks it through. So the ends are kind of more well done and the centre's slightly medium.
For her starter, she boils lemon juice with chicken stock as a base for salmon cakes with sweet butter sauce.
I enjoy all fish, and that will probably be really quite tasty.
I've no idea what a salmon cake is anyway, so it might be nice.
Kathy combines the fish, mash and herbs and rolls into balls to deep fry later.
The knack to this is make sure everything's really chilled. Otherwise, they fall apart.
A bit like hosting a dinner party, really. Almost done, she boils an onion, potatoes and garlic in cream to make potato gratin. A side for the main.
I've done as much as I can now, so I think I should go and get ready and get changed.
Glammed up in her requested formal attire, Kathy puts the beers on ice, ready for the first of her guests to feel the crunch of gravel underfoot. Prince of Ponytails, Pete.
Hello!
Hello, Peter! How are you? Cheers.
Cheers.
Nice to see you again.
Next to ascend the mansion steps is fairy mad mum, Kate.
Oh, my God.
Gorgeous.
I knew you lived in a council house.
I used to.
Oh, my God.
And finally, here's the maitre d'. Oh, no, hang on, it's Rick.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, look at you.
Well,
oh,
you
my
know.
God.
You OK?
Mm. Oh, you look gorgeous. Look at this.
Well, thank you very much. Did you not think it was within me?
No.
Coming up, the guests explore Castle Cathy.
Oh my God.
Kate gets critical.
Funny chipped one tooth.
I didn't like the grapefruit frog spawn thing in the bowl.
And the results are revealed.
In second place.
It's the final night in Merseyside, and Cathy Frost's turn to try to out-host her rivals and win enough money to pay her heating bill for a couple of days.
Chandeliers everywhere.
With all three guests present and correct, time to take in the surroundings.
Oh, my God.
We're going to fit on there.
This is just the best house I've ever, ever been into.
Mind you, this time last night you said that about mine.
Saying that, did you?
Back in the East Wing, Cathy heats the butter sauce for her starter.
Oh, my God.
And then deep fries her salmon fish cakes.
Healthy dish. Not.
Their own cinema.
Oh my God.
It's got a popcorn machine.
A big screen.
Can't believe we're in a lift in a house.
It's really nice. And if I had a couple of million pounds to throw around, I might just buy one.
Does wealth bring happiness?
Jealous, are we?
Apparently so.
That'll be a yes, then. Well, Cathy's hoping her starter will bring happiness as she continues her attempt to upstage Rick with salmon cakes in sweet butter sauce.
Your house is beautiful, Cathy. It really is out of this world. I've never been in a house like this ever before.
Thank you.
It was a lift in the house, please.
You thought you were boss with a stammer.
I know, yeah.
She's got the whole
house. Mmm. Do you like fish?
Mmm.
They had a great crisp texture. They weren't soggy and overdone. The sauce that it came with was quite refreshing. Good piquante to it. I liked it.
It was really tasty. It was very enjoyable.
Cathy's bid for the £1,000 prize is off to a good start. Moving on to the main, she browns cumin and cardamom seeds, then fries carrots, thyme, orange zest, and finally sugar.
It just takes any sort of acidity out of it, so it sort of sweetens it up a little bit and it helps kind of caramelise the onions slightly.
She fries asparagus in balsamic vinegar, carves the meat, and there it is, peppered fillet of beef with potato gratin and veg.
It's gorgeous. Well done, you.
Good. How do you like it?
It has to be served a little bit pinker for me. However, you know, considering the beef we've had on the other two nights, it was a lot better.
Definitely the best beef of the week.
Is there anything that you'll take out of the week?
I think I've learned you can't necessarily judge a book by its cover.
Mm. We thought Pete was normal and look at him.
What about you, Lovejoy?
Well, with me, every book is made up of different chapters.
You know you're like an onion. You've got layers, you have.
You know, funny thing about onions, they, people think that's the only veg that makes you cry. Unless you've been hit in the face by a turnip.
No, that was one of the best gags you told all week.
He possibly could one day be the next Jimmy Tarbuck, but it's just not been panning out for the guy. And then off the cuff tonight, he comes out with the turnip gag.
He just doesn't give a poo where he is. He just loves it. You know, we could be in a wheelie bin and isn't life great?
Pete finally gets some appreciation. Shame it's 2 days too late. Back in the kitchen, Cathy's ready for her last stand, dessert. She doles out lashings of passion fruit sauce, positions her lemon posset and tops homemade shortbread with strawberries.
And that, with two glasses of wine, that covers your five a day for about a fortnight, in my book.
And there you have it, an oh-so-decadent trio of puds.
Oh, a bit crunchy, aren't you?
But you know, you know what I mean? See, I should have taken them out of the fridge a bit earlier, but
I've only chipped one tooth. I loved the shortbread with the clotted cream and the strawberries. I didn't like the grapefruit frog spawn thing in the bowl. That wasn't my cup of tea.
Okay, highlights of the week, Pete.
When your particular celebrity came in with that plate of chicken. Being saved by a star off What was it called?
Brit.
We haven't actually talked about it.
Wouldn't you still do this whole thing, you know, if there was no monetary prize at the end? You would, wouldn't
you?
It's not about.
I would.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'll be the first one to say, I want that £1,000.
Yeah.
I want it. I need it. I need a holiday. Yeah, my head's battered. Yeah. But if I don't win it,
well, that's just as well, because you're not going to win.
I will bloody hate you all if I come forward.
You won't do that, don't worry, you won't do that.
I know my place.
Well, I think we'll see each other again.
Yeah, we will. So.
We're destined to. He'll tell you that.
It's, yeah.
You destiny. Know that.
These destiny. Things happen.
Cheers to us.
Cheers to all of us.
Cheers.
Cheers.
All of us.
Oh, enough of all that. You're making me queasy. Time to find out if Kathy's done enough to beat Rick's 26 points.
Kathy has been an excellent hostess tonight. Had a really good night with some good food. So I'm going to award Kathy an 8.
Life's great and I'm going to give Kathy an 8.
Tonight at Kathy's, it's been a great night. We've had some fantastic food. It's been laid back. It's been chilled out. Good atmosphere.
Whoa there! You'll have to wait to hear what Rick's given her. All the scoring's in secret, so it's up to Kathy to reveal who's won the £1,000 cash prize.
OK, this is the biggie.
Woo! Okay.
Oh. Are you ready for this? Control yourself. Fourth place. Are you ready?
Go on.
Kate!
Oh, my God!
Congratulations! I never thought it would happen.
OK, in third place, Peter.
Hey, well done, you.
In second place, Kathy. Which means Rick, baby. Hey, congratulations.
Rick scored Kathy a 7, putting her in second place.
Well deserved.
Aww. Well done.
The whole package of Rick and his entertainment and everything he put together was great. And I think that's what won everybody over. And it won me over. And it, you know, I've become a Rick convert now after that.
I think it was robbed of fourth, actually.
I've absolutely loved it. And he deserves it. That was his night, was fab.
I'm not quite sure what I'm going to spend it on, to be honest with you. I'm just taking it all in at the moment, but possibly a vacation. I don't know.
How about something pink?
An old man looks back on a very eventful life. Jim Broadbent heads a star cast as Any Human Heart begins this Sunday at 9. Back to tonight, and at 10, a plan to avoid sleeping with Jessica Alba. Complicated comedy in Good Luck, Chuck. But next, loyalties are tested and a saboteur is suspected in the event.
Your life is a sham.
Ben, and isn't life great?
Pete finally gets some appreciation. Shame it's 2 days too late. Back in the kitchen, Kathy's ready for her last stand, dessert. She doles out lashings of passion fruit sauce, positions her lemon posset, and tops homemade shortbread with strawberries.
And that, with 2 glasses of wine, that covers your 5 a day for about a fortnight, in my book.
And there you have it, an oh-so-decadent trio of puds.
Oh, a bit crunchy, aren't
you? But, you know what I mean? See, I should have taken them out of the fridge a bit earlier, but...
I've only chipped one tooth. I loved the shortbread with the clotted cream and the strawberries. I didn't like the grapefruit frog spawn thing in the bowl. That wasn't my cup of tea.
OK, highlights of the week, Pete.
When your particular celebrity came in with that plate of chicken, being saved by a star of... What was it called?
Brit.
Wouldn't you still do this whole thing, you know, if there was no monetary prize at the end? You would,
yeah,
wouldn't you? It's not about.
I would.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'll be the first one to say, I want that £1,000.
Yeah.
I want it, I need it, I need a holiday, my head's battered. Yeah. But if I don't win it, well, then.
So. Well, that's just as well, because you're not going to win.
I will bloody hate you all if I come forward.
You won't do that, don't worry, you won't do that.
I know my place.
Well, I think we'll see each other again.
Yeah, I think so.
We're destined to. He'll tell you that.
It's, yeah. You destiny. Know that. These destiny. Things happen.
It's to
cheers
us.
It's to all of us.
Cheers. Cheers. All of us.
Oh, enough of all that. You're making me queasy. Time to find out if Kathy's done enough to beat Rick's 26 points.
Kathy has been an excellent hostess tonight. Had a really good night with some good food. So I'm going to award Kathy an 8.
Life's great, and I'm going to give Kathy an 8.
Tonight at Kathy's, it's been a great night. We've had some fantastic food. It's been laid back. It's been chilled out. Good atmosphere.
Whoa there! You'll have to wait to hear what Rick's given her. All the scoring's in secret, so it's up to Kathy to reveal who's won the £1,000 cash prize.
OK, this is the biggie.
Woo!
Oh. Are you ready for
this?
Control yourself. Fourth place. Are you ready?
Go on.
Kate! Oh, my
congratulations.
God!
Congratulations! I never thought it would happen.
OK, in third place... Peter!
Hey, well done, you.
In second...
And not that gay men can't have kids, obviously.
Maybe he's a gay dad and he's adopted two kids. Or maybe he's just had two kids before he was gay.
He's not gay!
Maybe he's just not gay. And just really quite pretty.
Look, he isn't gay!
There's absolutely nothing wrong if he was gay. But I'm just none the wiser.
Rick is not gay! Have you got that, everyone? Now let's get back to the food, and once again the host hasn't touched hers.
It's nice. I can't eat that, I don't like it.
You don't eat your own food, do you, girl?
Don't like it.
I didn't like my potato. I thought the look put me off it. The sort of blob on the plate of pink, sort of dog sickish looking things.
Presentation absolutely fantastic for a children's party.
Meat and two veg for a main course. You can't go far wrong. But she kind of did.
If you could swap places with anybody, who would it be?
Louise Redner.
Why, can she cook?
Well, that was obviously...
I wonder why.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good answer, actually.
Peter.
Me? Oh, no doubt. Johnny Depp's wife. Because Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
Peter's the only thing we should know about you.
Are you gay, Peter? Are you coming out
here? Are you gay?
Here we go again.
No, but for Johnny Depp, yeah, probably.
Oh, the love that cannot be.
He fancies, you know, Captain Jack Sparrow, which was a bit bizarre.
I personally prefer women, but I can fully understand when women go for those sorts of men.
What would you do with £1 million?
Pay off my debts.
My God.
You've got £1 million worth
really?
Of debts.
It's
slightly under you.
Half, yeah.
Oh, my God.
You need to go bump.
Got to do a little duke in your
yeah, mean. That's the one. You know? More like a share guy.
I'm very curious now.
It doesn't matter how much money you owe. It's only the amount of money you've got left that you can pay. You know when you've got nothing left to give to anyone? They can't chase you anymore.
I don't know, I'd be like...
I'm not sure about that, Peter.
It was something that we were really not expecting. As to whether that's completely true, I'm not too sure. I don't possibly think it is £1 million.
I still owe £350,000.
To have that amount of money and that debt hanging over your head, I think it would... I wouldn't like it. I wouldn't feel happy.
Let's recap, Pete. You want to live with Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
OK. You've got £1 million worth of debt and you've never been happier?
Yeah.
Cheers, Pete. Hope to be in your shoes for the day.
And from the ridiculous to the even more ridiculous.
Dun, dun, dun. I love it. Looks fab.
It looks radioactive.
My main course was... So hopefully this will pull me back.
Well, I guess anything's possible when you believe in fairies, Kate. There we have it.
Breast implants, but, you know, we'll get them out anyway.
More like Jordan's cast-offs, you mean? Here it is, beef in orange sauce with that weird mustard mash and, of course, more fairy magic. Yay.
I'm just going to check. This blue dust is edible, isn't it?
No.
All right.
Don't eat, told you. Don't eat the blue dust.
That's it. Have I got blue on my teeth?
While the guests tuck into their second dose of fairy magic, chat turns to other sorts of small people.
And do you want more kids, is it, in general, or are you not sure about that yet?
I'm not sure about that. I don't know.
You wouldn't want him to be an only child, though, would you?
Well, we could get a dog. Have you got any kids, Rick?
I have two kids. My daughter's a teenager. And my son's just getting onto that now, past that. So, yeah, they're good.
I was very surprised when Rick said he had children because I thought he was gay.
He isn't gay.
And not that gay men can't have kids, obviously.
Maybe he's a gay dad and he's adopted two kids. Or maybe he's just had two kids before he was gay.
He's not gay.
Maybe he's just not gay and just really quite pretty.
Look, he isn't gay.
There's absolutely nothing wrong if he was gay, but I'm just none the wiser.
Rick is not gay! Have you got that, everyone? Now let's get back to the food, and once again, the host hasn't touched hers.
It's nice.
I can't eat that, I don't like it.
You don't eat your own food, do you, girl?
Don't like it.
I didn't like my potato. I thought the look put me off it. The sort of blob on the plate of pink, sort of dog sickish looking things.
Presentation absolutely fantastic for a children's party.
Meat and two veg for a main course. You can't go far wrong. But she kind of did.
If you could swap places with anybody, who would it be?
Louise Redner.
Why, can she cook?
Well, that was obviously...
I wonder why. Yeah, that's a good answer, actually.
Peter.
Me? Oh, no doubt. Johnny Depp's wife. Because Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
He's just the only thing we should know about you.
Are you gay, Peter?
Are you coming out
here? Are you gay?
Here we go again.
No, but for Johnny Depp, yeah, probably.
Oh, the love that cannot be.
He fancies, you know, Captain Jack Sparrow, which was a bit bizarre.
I personally prefer women, but I can fully understand when women go for those sorts of men.
What would you do with £1 million?
Pay off my debts.
My God.
You've got £1 million worth
really?
Of debt.
Slightly under you.
Half, yeah.
Oh, my God.
You need to go bump.
Got to a little Luke in your
ear. Yeah, that's the one. You know? More like a share guy.
I'm very curious now.
It doesn't matter how much money you owe. It's only the amount of money you've got left that you can pay.
That's a bit sad.
We haven't actually talked.
Wouldn't you still do this whole thing, you know, if there was no monetary prize at the end? You would,
yeah,
wouldn't you? It's not about.
I would.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'll be the first one to say, I want that £1,000.
Yeah.
I want it, I need it, I need a holiday, my head's battered. Yeah. But if I don't win it, well, then.
So, well, that's just as well, because you're not going to win.
I will bloody hate you all if I come forward.
You won't do that, don't worry, you won't do that. I know my place.
Well, I think we'll see each other again.
Yeah,
we're destined to. He'll tell you that.
It's, yeah.
You
destiny.
Know that.
These
destiny.
Things happen.
Cheers to us.
Cheers to all of us.
Cheers.
Cheers.
All of us.
Oh, enough of all that. You're making me queasy. Time to find out if Cathy's done enough to beat Rick's 26 points.
Cathy has been an excellent hostess tonight. Had a really good night with some good food. So I'm going to award Cathy an 8.
Life's great and I'm going to give Cathy an 8.
Tonight at Cathy's, it's been a great night. We've had some fantastic food. It's been laid back. It's been chilled out. Good atmosphere.
Whoa there! You'll have to wait to hear what Rick's given her. All the scoring's in secret, so it's up to Cathy to reveal who's won the £1,000 cash prize.
OK, this is the biggie.
Woo!
Oh. Are you ready for this? Control yourself. Fourth place. Are you ready?
Go on.
Oh, Kate.
Oh, my
Congratulations.
God.
Congratulations. I never thought it would happen.
OK, in third place, Peter.
Hey, well done, you.
In second place, Kathy. Which means Rick, baby. Hey! Congratulations.
Rick scored Kathy a 7, putting her in second place.
Well deserved.
Aww. Well done.
The whole package of Rick and his entertainment and everything he put together was great. And I think that's what won everybody over. And it won me over. And it, you know, I've become a Rick convert now after that.
I think it was robbed of fourth, actually.
I've
absolutely loved it. And he deserves it. That was his night, was fab.
I'm not quite sure what I'm going to spend it on, to be honest with you. I'm just taking it all in at the moment, but possibly a vacation, I don't know.
How about something pink? I am what I am. An old man looks back on a very eventful life. Jim Broadbent heads a star cast as Any Human Heart begins this Sunday at 9. Back to tonight, and at 10, a plan to avoid sleeping with Jessica...
When someone else cooks.
Yeah, that's the theory.
The beef was overcooked for me. It was dry.
The vegetables were all a bit grey-looking.
He'd done his little potatoes in a little whipped thing, which my dinner lady used to do. It's not good.
Still, at least the conversation's tasteful.
Do you do life drawings?
Used to, yes, did quite you, often, yeah. I think I may well be doing one this week, actually.
Volunteering herself, on.
Am I, yeah?
There's a couple tucked away in a bedroom you could look at.
If he offers to show you his etchings, just say no.
That's an offer, isn't it?
Yeah. All right, please.
Are you subtle?
Don't be shy.
I'll get these two. They're only pastels, and they were done quite a while ago. These are quite old, and these were done for teaching.
Wow. That's good.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Looks like me.
I was going to say, oh, there's me. Photograph. Big boobs, red hair.
Yeah.
Well, no, boobs aren't big enough.
Oi, Rick, you've been looking.
I wouldn't let him paint me naked, no. No, 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 no.
What if he told you a little joke first?
Right, so he used to do a bit of stand-up comedy because he used to run bars and clubs. You know.
You're going to give us a sample?
Yeah, go on.
Go on. Go on, go on. Go on, go on.
Go for it.
I walked by a shop the other day and I saw a 50-inch plasma TV, can't turn the volume down. I thought, stuck on full, I thought, well, I can't turn that down.
Get off!
We'll go to the others. All right, then, we'll go to the others.
Pete tonight came out with another revelation that he was a stand-up comic.
I don't know who taught him, but they're not very good at the job.
For his next comic creation, Pete smears meringue over ice cream and a flan base.
The only tricky thing about this is the speed. You've got to get it all in the oven while the ice cream's still frozen.
And judging by that, you've failed. Here it is anyway, Pete's Baked Alaska.
Actually, that was quick. You did that.
It's got to be, but not quick enough, I don't think.
Well, it's definitely funnier than his jokes.
I'm not. Oh, God, the giggles.
Are you
okay? I'm fine, I've got no giggles.
Oh, what's Kate found on a spoon? Don't wipe it on the table.
Pete, I apologise for these two.
Better get them out of here. Taxis!
It's just terrible. It was just chopped up. Stale bread with 6 different flavours of ice cream. Oh, and I felt really mean, but then I found a cat hair and I pulled it out and I had to wipe it on the dining table, really.
Me? But it's ready to go anyway. Roast beef with Duchess potatoes and seasonal veg.
It's always nicer than when somebody else does it for you.
Yeah. Well, doesn't it always taste nicer when someone else cooks?
Yeah, that's the theory.
The beef was overcooked for me. It was dry.
The vegetables were all a bit grey-looking.
He'd done his little potatoes in a little whipped thing, which my dinner lady used to do. It's not good.
Still, at least the conversation's tasteful.
Do you do life drawings?
Used to, yes, did quite you, often, yeah. I think I may well be doing one this week, actually.
Volunteering herself, on.
Am I, yeah?
There's a couple tucked away in a bedroom you could look at.
If he offers to show you his etchings, just say no.
That's an offer, isn't it?
Yeah. All right, please.
Are you subtle?
Don't be shy.
I'll get these two. They're only pastels, and they were done quite a while ago. These are quite old, and these were done for teaching.
Wow.
That's good.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
Looks like me.
I was going to say, oh, there's me. Photograph. Big boobs, red hair.
Yeah.
Well, no, boobs aren't big enough.
Oi, Rick, you've been looking.
I wouldn't let him paint me naked, no. No, 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 no.
What if he told you a little joke first?
Right, so he used to do a bit of stand-up comedy because he used to run bars and clubs. You know.
You're going to give us a sample?
Yeah, go on.
Go on, go on, go on. Go on.
Go for it.
I walked by a shop the other day and I saw a 50-inch plasma TV, can't turn the volume down. I thought, stuck on full, I thought, well, I can't turn that down.
Get off!
We'll go to the others. All right, then, we'll go to the others.
Pete tonight came out with another revelation that he was a stand-up comic.
I don't know who taught him, but they're not very good at the job.
For his next comic creation, Pete smears meringue over ice cream and a flan base.
The only tricky thing about this is the speed. You've got to get it all in the oven while the ice cream's still frozen.
And judging by that, you failed. Here it is anyway, Pete's Baked Alaska.
Actually, that was quick. You did that.
It's got to be, but not quick enough, I don't think.
Well, it's definitely funnier than his jokes.
Oh, God, the giggles.
Are you OK?
I'm fine, I've got no giggles.
Have another
wine. Oh, what's Kate found on a spoon? Don't wipe it on the table.
Pete, I apologise for these two.
Better get them out of here. Taxis!
It's just terrible. It was just chopped up.
I mean, I would say it properly. Every time you say that, one dies.
I don't believe in fairies. Oops, that's another one gone.
If someone says that in my house...
Should we be letting her near knives? Anyway, for her main course, Kate is making beef in orange sauce with mustard mash and sparkly glittery fairy magic.
Sounds right up my street.
Liverpool's hit music station.
I'm Rick Vaughan. This is Radio City 96.7. Thanks for switching us on.
Meet contestant number two, local radio DJ Rick Vaughan.
The real Rick Vaughan is the person you're looking at right now. Good looking, humorous, witty. Did I mention good looking?
Sadly, yes.
A lot of people would look at me again and say, oh, you're a celebrity, you're this guy, you're that guy. But if somebody is very fortunate enough in life to be born with a gift and they can show that gift to people, then good on them.
You're a DJ on local radio?
Celebrity culture is a complete waste of space, isn't it? You know, and I sit in the hairdressers and I read magazines with celebrity things and I think, what do they do?
Not a heat reader, then. This week's third competitor is straight-talking lady of comfortable means, Kathy Frost.
Well, my husband's reasonably successful, does it, you know, has got a good business and we've been lucky.
Very lucky!
Yes, I'm just an ordinary working-class girl from Birkenhead.
Who owns a fountain? Back in Fairyland, Kate's frying onion and peppers before adding diced beef to the pan.
Ow!
Barely finger.
Careful! She transfers the mixture to a slow cooker and adds beef stock.
I've just realised I've forgotten the most important thing. An orange, considering it's called beef and orange.
Yeah, that might help.
Ow, just grated me hand.
Yeah, that won't help. She adds orange juice and zest to the mixture.
The orange looks like little floaters.
Nice image. She leaves the beef to slow cook and it's onto the starter. Leek and potato soup with, you guessed it, fairy sprinkles.
I must admit, there's times in the past when I've dressed up as a fairy for parties. That's a different story.
And one we really don't want to hear. This week's lineup is completed by artist, life coach, raconteur, you name it, he's done it, Peter Worthington.
I think I'm a happy person because I've learnt over years it's no good being unhappy. So I feel happy at whatever I've got. If I've got no money, I'm happy. If I've got lots of money, I'm happy. If I've got friends around, I'm happy.
Do you think he's happy? Meanwhile, Kate sweats garlic, onions and leeks before adding potatoes and finally vegetable stock.
I'm going to leave that now for 40 minutes just to let it bubble away and let the potatoes soften. So that's cool. So now it's pavlova time.
For a children's party.
Meat and two veg for a main course. You can't go far wrong. But she kind of did.
If you could swap places with anybody, who would it be?
Louise Redknapp.
Why can she cook?
Well, that was
Yeah, that's a good answer, actually.
Peter?
Me? Oh, no doubt. Johnny Depp's wife. Because Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
Peter's the only thing we should know about
you.
Are you gay, Peter?
Are you coming out
here? Are you gay?
Here we go again.
No, but for Johnny Depp, yeah, probably.
Oh, the love that cannot be.
He fancies, you know, Captain Jack Sparrow, which was a bit bizarre.
I personally prefer women, but I can fully understand when women go for those sorts of men.
What would you do with £1 million?
Pay off my debts.
My God.
You've got £1 million worth
really?
Of debts.
Slightly under, yeah.
Half, yeah.
Oh, my God.
You need to go bump.
Got to a little nuke in your
yeah,
mean.
That's the one. You know? More like a share guy.
I'm very curious now.
It doesn't matter how much money you owe. It's only the amount of money you've got left that you can pay. You know, when you've got nothing left to give to anyone, they can't chase you anymore.
I don't know, I'd be like...
I'm not sure about that, Peter. I'm not sure about that.
It was something that we were really not expecting. As to whether that's completely true, I'm not too sure. I don't possibly think it is £1 million.
I still owe £350,000.
To have that amount of money and that debt hanging over your head, I think it would... I wouldn't like it. I wouldn't feel happy.
Let's recap, Pete. You want to live with Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
OK. You've got £1 million worth of debt and you've never been happier?
Yeah.
Cheers, Pete. Hope to be in your shoes for the day.
And from the ridiculous to the even more ridiculous.
Dun, dun, dun. I love it. Looks fab.
It looks radioactive.
My main course was... So hopefully this will pull me back.
Well, I guess anything's possible when you believe in fairies, Kate. There we have it. More kids' party food. Fairy fruit pavlova.
It's colourful.
I like the colour in it, yeah.
Yeah, it's got plenty of colour going on.
It's like something you see in The Simpsons.
Or in a dentist's nightmare.
We're all going to be on a sugar buzz
like
after this.
Anyway.
With glucose levels rocketing, the host seizes the opportunity to pop her ultimate question.
Do you believe in fairies?
No, absolutely
not. I'm going to be more diplomatic than that.
No, I'm just being... Absolutely not.
Another fairy bites the dust?
I think, listen, if you believe in something like that and it's what you believe in, then good on you.
Yeah. I believe in taxis.
That dessert, it sort of... It reeked of Kate all over.
I don't think she... I don't know what a fairy fruit is, apart from a fairy fruit, like a kiwi fruit, slightly fairy on the outside.
It's normally with fairy fruit to throw that away, it's off.
Well, let's clear things up. Kate cakes her cream-covered meringue in fairy fruit, which actually is just fruit.
That is just amazing. You can't possibly ruin it by putting fairy dust on.
Oh, yes, you can.
Oh, it's like magic beans.
Ever heard that less is more?
Ta-da! I love it. Ah, dead happy. I'm going to put it in the fridge.
Please do. My fillings are aching.
Oh, my God, I don't want to eat it. It looks that good.
Glad rags on, and Kate's ready to welcome her first guest into the fairy grotto. And fittingly, it's gnomish life coach Peter.
Hiya, Peter. Nice to meet you. I'm Kate.
Hello, Kate.
Okay, it's Tim. Come on in. Oh, thank you very much.
Next in is the lady of the manor, Kathy.
Hi!
Come.
Nice to meet you.
And you?
Kathy.
Hiya, Kathy. I'm Kate. Who do we think's going to be next?
I think it's going to be a female.
Even I can't be that lucky, and I've been blessed by the gods.
Aww. What with smarm?
But then again...
You never know.
Talking of smarm, here's self-proclaimed gift from the gods, Rick.
Hello.
Hello there.
How are you?
Great. Nice to meet you. I'm Rick.
And you are you, Rick? I'm Kate.
Hello,
Come on
Kate.
In. Come on in. Take a seat. Everybody's through there. Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Coming up, bewilderment.
It's just terrible.
Bizarreness.
Johnny Depp is absolutely gorgeous.
Which was a bit bizarre.
And battle stations.
I was more than happy last night to let Pete have his sort of 5 minutes of fame, and I'm prepared to let that continue up until a point.
Merseyside mum of one, Kate McDonald, is throwing a dinner party for three strangers in a bid to win a £1,000 cash prize.
So what do you do, Rick?
My main job is I work for Radio City.
Oh, do you? Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. So I work there.
Fab. What do you do there?
Radio show. I do 10 in the morning till 2 in the afternoon.
Oh, grill. That's where I know your voice from, then.
You've actually heard of him?
Yes. It's none of them dodgy numbers you've been ringing.
No.
Maybe he does those as well.
They kind of put two and two together and said, oh, I recognise the voice, or I've seen you, or someone similar to that.
When he said, I'm Rick Vaughan, I was like, yeah, and, you know.
Do you guys want to come and take a seat? Sit down.
Cross swords, dueling banjos.
No, I am, sorry. I'm having Rick Vaughan here tonight for dinner. There you go.
Clash of the Titans. Cannonball.
I bet they're your mates too. Kathy begins by boiling cream and sugar for just one of her trio of desserts. Lemon posset, passion fruit sauce and strawberry shortbread.
Interesting.
Ooh, that sounds nice, doesn't it?
Doesn't it just? Once the cream for the posset has cooled, Kathy adds lemon juice and zest, pours into shot glasses and sets aside to cool. She makes simple shortbread biscuits.
I don't want anyone saying I bought my shortbread.
And finally, a sauce from passion fruit and lemon curd.
That's it, in the fridge. Chill.
Next, Kathy sears the meat for her main. Peppered fillet of beef with spiced vegetables.
Get in there, that's what I wanted.
Again, we're getting the predictable meat and two veg scenario.
Hang on, you serve chicken and veg.
Because Kathy's doing a fillet of beef, with a fillet it'll be cooked in a very particular way.
Spot on, Sherlock.
I'm going to wrap it in the foil to keep it hot, and the heat from the foil kind of cooks it through. So the ends are kind of more well done and the centre's slightly medium.
For her starter, she boils lemon juice with chicken stock as a base for salmon cakes with sweet butter sauce.
I enjoy all fish, and that will probably be really quite tasty.
I've no idea what a salmon cake is anyway, so it might be nice.
Kathy combines the fish, mash and herbs and rolls into balls to deep fry later.
The knack to this is make sure everything's really chilled, otherwise they fall apart.
A bit like hosting a dinner party, really. Almost done, she boils an onion, potatoes and garlic in cream to make potato gratin, a side for the main.
I've done as much as I can now, so I think I should go and get ready and get changed.
Glammed up in her requested formal attire, Kathy puts the beers on ice, ready for the first of her guests to feel the crunch of gravel underfoot. Prince of Ponytails, Pete.
Hello!
Hello, Peter!
How are you?
Cheers.
Thank you so much.
You again.
Next to ascend the mansion steps is fairy mad mum, Kate.
Oh, my God.
Gorgeous.
I knew you lived in a council house.
I used to.
Oh, my God.
And finally, here's the maitre d'. Oh, no, hang on, it's Rick.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, look at you.
What? Somebody's pleased with himself.
While we're in the mood, all jelly and custard.
That was just amazing. That was really, really good. It just got the night going.
Rich gentlemen have it, boys, in digestion.
They gave out some quality tunes tonight.
Que sera, sera. Whatever will be, will be.
I thought the entertainment of the band was brilliant, but I don't think you would organise, you would do something like that if you didn't want to, you know, perpetuate the gay thing. Why would you?
But he's not gay, Kathy. Back in the kitchen, and it's almost time for the main event.
We are anticipating a special guest to deliver the main course, who should be here any second now. And it's going to be a real thrill for the guys, I think.
Well, there it is, Rick's roast chicken, about to be served by a very special guest. Here he comes!
We just need the chicken, as promised, for the roast. And I thought it'd be a great idea to get it served up for you guys by none of this nonsense, a true celebrity.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Elton... Hang on a minute, who's that?
Look at that! Isn't that the finest chicken you've ever seen?
Dean
Dean Sullivan, everybody.
Oh, it's Jimmy Corkill from Brookside. Yeah, well, Elton must have been busy.
Thanks so much.
Jimmy Corkill.
Calm down.
Thank you.
I grew up watching Brookside, Jimmy Corkill and Jackie. And there he is walking out. All right, I got the chicken.
Do you know what? And that was one of the big things about tonight and my night in general. I wanted to try and create that sort of celebrity feel to the night for us, just so it was memorable for you, that's all.
Thank you, oh great one.
It was slightly patronising for Rick to say, I'm doing this for you people who may never meet celebrities, because he thinks that, you know, we're all no marks.
Go on, there you go. Famous person.
Famous person. I've met Bill Clinton.
Have you?
Had dinner with Bill Clinton, and he looked down my dress, looked down my cleavage.
A lot of men do that.
No, I met the Queen, and she was really cute, actually, because she's only little.
Amazing experience.
And it was nice to go home and say to my kids, I met the Queen today.
Yeah? Back at you, Rick.
We'd had, you know, maybe little celebrities that we've all kind of met, but not the President of the United States. That's big.
I mean, I've met Prince Charles a dozen times. I've only been to two of the Queen's garden parties. But I don't feel the need to talk about it.
You just did. Let's roll out the red carpet for the food.
The chicken was cooked to perfection.
Those roasties were lovely. They were done in goose fat, and I love goose fat.
So far, so good in his bid for the £1,000 prize. Time for the final act of...